On a day when the Edmonton Oilers made a splash in free agency as the free agent period opens up in the National Hockey League, it's pretty fitting, Bob, that we stand in front of Ice District and the almost ready Rogers Place, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Peter Chiarelli today adding another building block to the team building that is the Edmonton Oilers. And we heard a lot of discussion over the course of the last 3 or 4 days about the viability of Milan Lucic coming to Edmonton. And they get the one player in the league that is like Milan Lucic, and that is Lucic because he is unique. He is a difference maker for an organization. He has leadership skills. He brings a dimension that has been lacking for the Oilers for a number of years, maybe since all the way back to Bill Guerin, and that's a power forward that can do pretty much everything.
That was a
heck of a player, and they're going to have lots of other support now for the likes of guys like Patrick Maroon and Cassian. So Peter's been true to his word as well, Tom. He's rebuilt the goaltending, Cam Talbot, he picked him up last year at the draft, added some size, first Cassian, who they later re-signed at a bit of a haircut, then he gets the Maroon deal done, and now the big step to get Milan Lucic long-term.
And it kind of fills that void left by the Taylor Hall trade as well a little bit. What does this do about the culture of the team, Bob? Does it start to shift to what Peter maybe envisioned when he took this job a year ago?
Yeah, and I'll never take anything, as nor will you, from Taylor Hall, because he succeeded during very difficult times in Edmonton, a lot of different changing in coaches and management philosophies and that
100%.
Sort of thing. But that being said, Milan Lucic has won before, and Taylor Hall allowed the Oilers to get themselves a defenseman that can step in on the right side and play 22 minutes a game and play hard. The Oilers are a bigger, more physical, difficult team to play against. And the last time I checked, unless you can get out of the Pacific Division, you can't win the Stanley Cup. And Chiarelli, who's won a cup like Lucic before, is trying to build a club that is capable of winning the Stanley Cup.
Okay, briefly, the other moves the Oilers made today. Mark Fraser, we're familiar with. He was a member of the Edmonton Oilers a couple of years ago. A depth move on D, and then in goal, Jonas Gustavsson comes in. Just, Bob, maybe your thoughts on bringing these two in, and where are the Oilers at in terms of filling other needs, specifically on the back end?
All right, well, Gustavsson, this is a scenario that buys him a little bit more time to develop Laurent Brossoit. I think that's a given. It's pretty clear at the end of the year. Laurent probably needs a little bit more time down in the American Hockey League. He's going to get the bulk of the starts to start the year. Of course, he will have a chance to compete for the job. As for Mark Fraser, they play in a tough division in the American Hockey League. In San Diego, Dallas Eakin's team had a lot of guys that could battle. Fraser will increase that on the back end for Edmonton at the AHL level, and if need be, can be a guy that can be called up in a short term and give the Oilers some minutes. And then where is Edmonton at? Peter's, again, true to his word. We had to address goaltending, had to change the complexion of the forward units, had to improve the defense. He's repeatedly stated that they'd like to get specifically a right side puck mover that can run a power play. Peter Chiarelli told me today that, he's comfortable with where the Oilers' defense is at to start the year. But one thing we've seen with Peter Chiarelli, and case in point, was the Maroon trade. He's working on it all the time. And I think at some point, the Oilers, at some point, may not be over the next 72 hours, may not be over the next 3 weeks, but at some point, the Oilers will address their defense, possibly taking from their depth at forward and getting themselves a guy that could potentially run the power play from the right side.
All right, Bob, undoubtedly a big day in oil country here. Very exciting as Milan Lucic joins the Edmonton Oilers for 7 years. Hey, development camp, orientation camp comes up next. Starts actually on Saturday. Bob, will we see you in Jasper, or is it just me flying solo with Westcott?
I think you guys, you're going to be tearing up that town from what I hear. They haven't let me back in from a couple years ago.
Hey, all right, we'll make up for you not being there. Tune in all week long, EdmontonOilers.com and Oilers TV, as always, has you covered.